Coach Snyder had mentioned that you and Trey really liked the leadership that you guys brought, especially in that final quarter. What was it about tonight that was so successful for you two to kind of go off and work off each other?
Just being solid, you know, believing in the whole group, believing in each other, you know, but mainly just staying solid, trying to take care of the ball and make the right decisions, whether it's for, you know, our teammate or ourselves, and obviously on the defensive end, staying together, and I think we did that.
DJ, congrats on the win tonight. Of course, this is your first home playoff game as a member of the Atlanta Hawks. Can you talk to me about the atmosphere in tonight's game and how it may have differed from the regular season?
I mean, they showed up and they showed out. You know, they was extremely loud. You know, whether we made shots, missed shots, turned the ball over, you know, they was with us. And I think that's all that matters. And that was a big part of the win tonight. And we're going to need, you know, the same energy or more on Sunday.
Thank you.
You mentioned yesterday that you had texted Trey the other day, I think when you guys got back from Boston. Can you just talk about what it's been, what you think it's been like for him the last couple days, and how he responded tonight?
And who cares what the media talk about? No disrespect to none of you guys. I respect everybody's job, first and foremost. But, you know, don't fall in love with praise, negativity. You know, that's pretty much my message to him. You know how to do it well. Coach Pop taught me how to really, really, you know, do it, being a young guy coming to the league. But, you know, just telling them to continue to come in and work, learn, play your game, be yourself, have fun, and compete at a high level.
Yeah, no disrespect, Dan. And as a follow-up, everybody knew it was going to be a process with you two kind of learning each other this year in the backcourt. Would you agree that this was one of the better games you guys have played together this year?
Absolutely. I mean, that's the thing about it, you know. You know, I don't want to talk about Boston too much, but, you know, I look at Jason and Jalen a lot. You know, two guys who was going through it a lot, just not working out, and just to get to where they're at, the level they're at. You know, obviously last year going to the finals, and then this year, you know, being, you know, at the top of the East. You know, so great things don't happen overnight, you know. And, you know, great things take time, and I think me and him, you know, both want to learn the game and work at the game at the same time. And, you know, great things don't happen overnight. And that's pretty much what I can say. You know, so we got to be consistent. I know it's a small window right now because it's the playoffs and it's not an 82 game season. So, you know, we got to just continue to be solid and, you know, want the best for each other.
Dejounte, you've been very encouraging with Jalen Johnson and just how he's performed over the season. What have you seen out of him in the postseason, and what advice, if any, have you given him?
Even with him, just stay confident. You know, they give you the shot, shoot the shot. Watch them take threes each and every day in practice. And like I said before, early in the season when I first got here, I'm big on, you know, me working, you know, so I'm not just telling guys, you know, what I see or what to do, and I'm not doing it. And, you know, I see him working each and every day, and you know, just want him to be confident, play his game, you know, rebounds, playing defense, all the little things. But they give you shots, take them, because you work at them. So he's going to be great. This is great for him. This is great for all of us, but, you know, mainly him, because his potential is out the roof.
DJ, a quick question. You talked about over here. You talked about having fun and the idea of enjoying the game. How important is that to offset the pressure that you could feel in the playoffs?
I mean, when you're competing at a high level, you kind of forget that you know, you do gotta have fun at it. You know, you gotta show emotions. You gotta, you know whatever you're doing, whatever it is. And obviously, we play basketball, so you know you want to have fun, but you know at the same time, you know, compete at a high level. So, you know, I think if you compete, number one, but also have fun, then, you know, you get great results.
DJ, you guys scored 74 points in the first half in this game. That was tied the most that you guys have scored all season. From your perspective, what would you say changed from game one to game two to coming into tonight's game in game three?
Confidence, ready to go from the jump. You know, obviously being at home helped really well. Like I said before, when we played them in the regular season, they kind of had a lot of cheers coming out and warm-ups, you know. So tonight, they was booed, and it felt like we was in Atlanta. You know, it felt like we had the whole city, the fan base behind us. And, you know, I think that rubbed off on us well. And like I said, we came ready to play from the jump all the way to the finish. And, you know, we got to carry it on Sunday.
Speaking of confidence, what makes you confident that you can repeat this performance on Sunday, even up the series against the Celtics?
Just staying confident, you know. We work hard, you know, we're learning a lot. Coach is throwing a lot at us, you know, but it's our job. You know, we're professionals. And like I said, just stay confident. One game at a time, we ain't do nothing. You know, and that's kind of the message that I was preaching in the locker room once I got in there. You know, it's great to get a win in the playoffs. But at the same time, we haven't done nothing. You know, we got a long way to go. You know, we believe in ourselves. So, and I think that's all that matters.
All right. Thanks, DJ. See you guys.